when we first got married, I had very unreal expectations in the ministry. I thought I had to be perfect, that I had to get up every morning and have the house in order and the children well-behaved and groomed and my makeup on. And I've learned through the years that I am happier in the ministry if I'm just who I am. And so for my church members, that's what I want them to know. I'm just a person that God has saved. He just happened to call me to be your wife, and he called me to this calling. But the ministry is not a profession. It's a calling, and every Christian has a calling. I want them to not expect more of me than they expect of themselves, but I also want to be the example to them. And so sometimes that's a fine line, and sometimes that can be very frustrating, that you want them to be mature when they're not mature yet. So in the ministry, I think you have to constantly take that seesaw and be able to balance it.
And I would say just our own experience and then knowing other pastors. We have a lot of pastors on our church staff. Sometimes the pastor is treated differently and the expectations are different with the pastor than the pastor's wives. And that means that sometimes wives feel this huge pressure to be a minister, to be a pastor. But first and foremost, for both pastors and pastors' wives, all ministers, we're to be people that love God.
That's right.
And the best thing, I think, as I've watched you over the years handle being a pastor's wife in all size churches. I mean, we've pastored churches with 13, 14 people in them, our first church, and then obviously a very large ministry today with Prestonwood. But here's the thing. If you are honest with people and if you love people, the ministry can be a happy life. I'm concerned when I see pastors and pastors' wives struggling so much to enjoy their calling. And I know there's pressures, and I know sometimes pastors and especially pastors' wives can be mistreated. But if you stay focused on your calling and stay committed to Christ, then you can let that stuff go. I mean, people are going to say things, they do things that upset you. It happens. But for the most part, we have lived a very blessed life.
Oh, yes.
And the people in our churches have given us so many opportunities to fulfill the calling that God has given us. So I can say after all these years, and I know you believe this too, this has been a great calling, a great life. I wish I had another 50 to do it all over again.
That's right.
It's hard sometimes, but what an encouragement it has been to serve God's people and to preach Christ and the gospel and to raise our family in the church. I know it's not easy sometimes for the kids to be in that fishbowl situation, to be preacher's kids. And you know why why preacher's kids turn out the way they do, right?
Yep.
They hang out with deacon's kids.
That's right.
And stuff like that. But the problem is, you know, for some pastor's kids, their parents are different at home than they see on the platform. And or the expectations for preacher's kids are beyond what their expectations should be just as Christians. We should never put on our children as pastors our rules, but only to guide them in terms of God's rules and the relationship that they have with Christ. So what I would say, you know, that people could pray for, not just us, but for their pastor and ministers in their churches, is to pray for them personally that they would know and love the Lord. And, you know, every pastor and pastor's wife, their children are very special to them. Pray for those children.
That's right.
Pray that their children will know the Lord and grow up and follow Him.
That's right.